Ivan? Sir Ivan?
Hi, Joel, and good afternoon to everyone. Good afternoon, Madam Secretary.
Yeah. Sir Ivan, ikaw naman, how have you been affected by the pandemic?
We have stopped operations. We've stopped all our tours in Manila, so we're not doing any walks right now.
Nakakasad naman yan. Pero sir, maybe you can expound on what you are planning to do or how you're pivoting. I'll give you a minute, sir. Go ahead. Tell our audience.
Okay, so basically we're a tour outfit, Old Manila Walk. So we do very thematic cultural and historical tours within the city of Manila, so in the old neighborhoods. And one of the tours that that we're known for, it's the Binon, the food walk, which is basically it's a cultural culinary walk around Binondo or Chinatown. Right now, as operations are currently on hold, we have been we've been trying to upgrade ourselves with skills and knowledge. You know, attending so many webinars from tourism to business related to F&B, even health related webinars, just so we could, you know, get insights and information and hopefully apply best practices when we do start operating again after the COVID pandemic. We've also been sharing expertise through webinars in other platforms, expertise on tourism, on heritage, and culture, which we are very much work within these industries.
Again, I like what I hear that you are not just sitting around. No, you are actually staying very active.
Yeah, yes, we are.
So, what do you think? When do you think this will end?
Hang on. I guess once people feel safe to travel, and once we get the vaccine, as what most tourism insiders would mention, once we get the vaccine, and then that's the time it will get back to the normal, hopefully sooner than later.
Sir, kasi for people like you who do walk tours na are so dependent on tourists, how long do you think you can survive na ganyan, na walang standstill yung tourism?
We do other stuff, no? I actually do other stuff apart from tourism. I'm also active with certain organizations on heritage, and we've been actually doing a lot of work during the ECQ. But of course, that's me, no? Others, tourism frontliners, are hit directly. Talagang no job, no. Mm-hmm. So I guess the thing right now for most tourism frontliners is that, you know, I see a lot of them pivoting or doing stuff just so they could, you know, it could tide them over until this all stops, no. From cooking to, you know, to gardening to doing entrepreneurship, selling stuff, ganyan.